So today was one of the shittiest days on record at work. And I went to lunch. Before I went to lunch, Andrew got with me. He's just basically freaking the fuck out. And then I made a joke that his mustache makes him look like a French aristocrat. Oui, oui, ha, ha, entrepreneur. And then when I came back from lunch, he's like, he came back. I was like, did you think I was going to leave? He's like, well, it's been a day. I'm like, yeah, it has. Hey, welcome to another edition of Inside You and Bill.
Raptor.
And we're back at it, back in studio tonight, which is fun. It's, yeah, we've lost so many episodes over the last couple, tries. Doing, what the fuck?
She just, like, wall texted me, like.
Wall texted you?
Baby. Like, wall texted me.
So tell her to shut the fuck up, we're recording! We've lost so many episodes doing this shit virtually that we had to get it back in studio. And the office now is looking like an actual office, Raptor. Well,
it
I mean,
is.
As much as you can make a home office out of something. I mean, it's a little, I have to vacuum, but I did get my finally, you know, sniper kills Kennedy, Johnson is president poster up. I got a smart TV down here now and a nice executive chair.
After all the times I've been bitching about a chair,
I know,
dude. I come down and I'm like, you got a fucking chair. Like, you dick.
I'm gonna have to get you one. While we're at it, I will say, this is not a paid sponsorship because I don't think they know that there's an app called QuadPay. I don't know if you've heard of it.
No, I haven't.
Okay. So, all you do is sign up and they approve you for an amount of like $200. I think it's $200. And then what it does is you could through their browser, you could shop on Walmart, Amazon, all that good stuff, like Nike and stuff. So when you go to check out, it'll generate a credit card number for you. Like you give them your debit card number for your account. And then when you shop and you go check out, it'll generate a debit card number for you and it'll use that number to pay for your order and ship it to you. And then it takes out of your bank account every 2 weeks.
Huh.
And it's wicked cool. And I have a small addiction to it.
Okay.
At one time, I had like 4 quad pays going on at the same time. Plus an Affirm, which is that thing through Walmart.
Yeah. Well, I mean, I've seen other places do it too.
Yeah. I mean, like, as soon as my credit score started going up, it was like, we have to have Affirm to pay for the Christmas gifts. I'm like, okay. So that's reporting to my credit score. That's a little scary. And then there's this thing called Afterpay.
Yes.
Yeah, I use that too.
Dude.
I had a little bit of a problem. Actually, mine are almost all paid off except for when did I quad pay? Oh no, I afterpaid this shirt, which is money, by the way.
That really is.
And, my tumbler that says Buffalo Bills Lotion Company upstairs. I've been drinking coffee out of it. And the t-shirt and the Tumblr are from hippierunner.com. Go there. They got a bunch of awesome shit. And everything's 50% off right now. So do that. How are you?
I'm all right. I'm a little tired.
We're all a little tired. I'm surprised you haven't made a crack about my lack of facial hair today.
I thought about it. And I'm like, no, I'm going to let it go.
So like the snowstorm last week, I called off of work because I couldn't go anywhere. And I was like, I told Stacey, I was like, next time you're on your frog, since I know we're not going to have sex, I'm just going to shave off my facial hair because she finds me utterly unattractive without any facial hair, as she should, because I look like a pedophile without any facial hair.
Yeah, you look weird.
Yeah. It's
like the week that I wouldn't talk to Phillips when he was shaving and his sister bumped him.
Yeah.
And then he had to shave his whole face. So I'm like, do not talk to me until you grow your face back.
Yeah. Because like, even without any facial hair, you don't even have to look at me and you could hear, come on, kid, get in the van. I got a little something good for you. Beetlejuice. you want a segment? I got a little something good for you. And she wasn't on the frog, but I did it anyway. She's like, oh, why'd you do it? She's like, it's not so bad. And it has, and my facial hair takes like notoriously long to grow back.
Yeah.
But I have kind of like a, like a,
you have a little bit like 5 o'clock shadow going.
Yeah. Well, it's more like a 7:30 shadow because yeah, it's been like this for a couple of days. But I do have like a mid thirties stubble thing going on. And thank God I have a good jawline. Cause if not, this would suck terribly. So you're tired.
Yeah.
And that's not a new thing.
No, it's not. It's
we're
really
always
not.
Tired.
I've been running like crazy.
As Jackson Brown would say, you're running on empty?
Yeah, pretty much. It's been, I don't know, between work and other shit and dealing with shit, and I'm exhausted. I actually left work the other day. Like
early?
Yeah.
Like, fuck it?
Yeah. Last week. With the snow and everything, like, we closed Monday.
Yeah. Walmart actually closed. Canceled third shift.
Wow.
Yeah. Which, that's only happened once when we were working overnights.
Yeah.
Yeah, when I got a call from Rob, we're fucking closing! Okay.
But, I took off Thursday because I took Ashley for her tattoo.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, I'm just good because I lost Monday. You know, I got my truck late. Everything's kind of backed up. It's like after I'm just going to go in for a couple hours, just do some stuff and all that. And I was there for like 3 hours and I'm like, nope, got to go. I had such a bad migraine.
Oh, dude.
I went home and went to bed.
It's those.
I went home. I changed. Like, I crawled in bed and she's like, just go to bed. So just go to bed.
It's those fucking days where you cannot get. Like, everything's hitting at you. Everything's, it's like a, it's like a bad Bukkake video.
Yeah.
Everything's coming at you all at once. Sorry for the Bukkake joke. No, that's fine. I'll wait. Okay. I'll have to edit that out. Everything's coming at you all at once. You can't catch it all.
Yeah.
And you just have to tap out and spit.
Yep. <It's> just... Yep.
Yeah, the other day. When was it? Thursday. Wednesday night, I went to bed at 11:30. I got up at 2 on my day off, which I hate that.
Yeah.
Hate that. Cause that was the shit when we were working third shift is that you're working 10 to 7, then you have a night off, but then, and you sleep during the day. So then you're just up.
Yeah.
And so I got up at 2. I'm playing Assassin's Creed until 7. And then Lennon had an eye appointment. So we went to that. And when we got home, Stacey went to work. I'm like, all right, I'm going to lay down for like 90 minutes. Lennon's up for a nap, lay down for 90 minutes. I laid there and just stared at the fucking back of the couch. Can't get to sleep. Like 9 o'clock rolled around. I'm like, I'm going to put these little bitches to bed. So I remember giving Lennon his eye drops, putting him to bed. I remember giving Sophie a kiss goodnight. And then my alarm went off. I lost like 15 minutes. And I was at work the next morning and Stacey's like, do you remember me coming into bed at all? I'm like, nope. New. No.
I've had nights like that. Like, seriously, Thursday night, I left work at like 7.
You guys close at what, 9?
9.
9.
Yeah. I left work at 7. Like, I got back to the house. Like, I changed. Like, I crawled in the bed and like.
That's it.
That was it. Like, she was getting ready to go to work, and I fucking crashed. She's like, just go to bed. I'm like, no! She's like, I was like, I gotta take you to work. She's like, no! Go to bed! I'm like, okay! And then that was it. And then, like, I just remember, like, coming home in the morning. Like, that was it.
That really is really good.
I like that one. I didn't think I would like that one.
Do you remember Pepsi Kona?
Yes.
Kind of tastes like that.
Yeah.
So the new Coca-Cola, also not a paid sponsorship, but I mean, hey, Coca-Cola, come on. Coca-Cola with coffee, the dark roast. That Pepsi Kona used to be my shit.
That was good.
Oh, so good. That's kind of reminiscent of it. I'd be good with some Kahlua.
Yeah.
I don't know, I have fucking Kahlua. All the alcohol I got in this house. They fucking Kahlua. Liquor store. Are they open on Sundays? They are open. Are they?
No.
Are you sure?
I don't think so.
Someone's acting like I don't have Google.
Right.
excuse me.
Oh, so I've also come to, well, not me.
Liquor store.
I told her I would save this for the podcast and mm-hmm. not tell you.
What have you done?
I haven't done anything.
Okay, what did she do?
She hasn't done anything, but we've come to the realization
they are open Sundays, 11 to 4.
Okay.
That's a narrow window.
Yeah, that is.
Before Stacey goes to work, I gotta get to the
liquor store. We have realized that I'm dating the female version of you.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, it is.
That's dangerous.
Yeah, it is.
It's all the perks of my sense of humor and sex.
Right?
well, fuck.
Yeah, I'm dating.
Like, am I honored?
I am dating the female version of you.
Like, you've been staring at my tits for years. I just thought you. I just thought you were Marvel.
I'm not a tit person.
Oh no. Well.
And I know you understand what I mean.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. Dating the female version of you.
You're welcome.
I don't know. Something happened the other day, and she's like, oh, I think she's listening to the podcast or something. She's been listening to back episodes at work.
That's,
yeah.
That's a lengthy catalog. Thanks, yeah. Ashley.
I don't know, and something happened, and then, like, she said something, and she's like, I am Bill, and I'm like, fuck! Like, oh my god, like, I'm dating my best friend.
Well... like, for years, it's like, I'm married, and our reproductive parts are compatible, but not compatible. But now, I don't.
Yeah.
Well,
so that's a new discovery in my life right now.
Well, I mean, if she has big old banana fingers like me, more power to you. Banana fingers. I don't have a pen to write that down. I do. Wait, banana fingers. I don't write that down.
But, like, she's been listening to the back catalog and, like, will, like, text me just, like, random shit that I've said.
I love getting those.
It's been like, what the fuck?
I love getting those because it's safe. It's, it's, cause most times I really forget what I say on this thing. I don't really have, we don't really have filters.
No.
So it's kind of just flying by the seat of our pants. And, like, even when I'm editing, because I listen to the whole thing while I'm editing, go in and take out loud spots, dark spots, amplifications, and it still won't, like, register, and I'll be sitting here laughing my ass off, like a kid who just farted in the bathtub. And then the show comes out, and I kind of part with it. I'll promote it, and then that's pretty much it. It's it's afterwards that, like, Phillips will kind of be like, you piece of shit. Like, you just don't stop. And I'm like, what did I do? What did I do? You knew, you know what the show's about. You don't need to come to me. And like, but, like, then I act surprised. I'm like, did I say that? It is fun, though. So, before we, get started on this week's, continue our series on the 80s. This is 1981.
Yes.
So we did a thing. We're now on TikTok.
Yes.
So, okay.
And I said I have a Snapchat promoter if we want to go that way.
I would like us to find our way through TikTok first. Because, like, okay, I started a personal TikTok maybe a week and a half ago. The third video I posted got close to 5,000 views. That did fucking, like, nothing for my ego. Like, come on.
It's like, oh, fuck. Cause, like, when I was saying that to her, like, I was like, I've mentioned this to you before. And then she's like, well, what about Snapchat? She's like, oh, no. Cause she texts me, she's like, I didn't know the podcast had a Snapchat. And I'm like, yeah, but it's not used. Oh, no. And, then she says something about TikTok. And I'm like, yeah, I was like, I've mentioned that to him. And then that's when she jumped in the group chat.
Yeah. Because, like, you can't turn it down. This app is, it's weird. Hey, this is weird. Like, I downloaded it maybe a year ago, I was flipping through it.
Like, I just scroll through it, like, when I'm laying in bed, like, just kind of some downtime. I normally watch it for a little bit, like, when she works at night. But other than that, like, I don't do any videos, like, but there are a couple people that, like, I'll follow that, like, I fucking love their videos.
Yeah. I tell you what.
And any of their content, there's this, because it all depends on what, like, you like and all that. Like, it'll put you in, like, this group of videos that you get. Mm-hmm. So now I'm getting all the lesbian videos. Well, I've been getting all the lesbian videos, but I get all the lesbian videos.
Apropos of your sexual orientation. Yeah.
But there's this couple on there.
You're a lesbian?
I'm sorry you had to find out this way. I'm sorry.
Oh, it was like a countdown in my head. I'm like, 3, 2, 1, go for it.
But like, there's this couple, and she'll just, the one will just give like cheesy pickup lines to her girlfriend, wife, whatever she is.
Yeah.
Like she was doing some like Harry Potter like pickup lines, some like Game of Thrones pickup lines, and then she'll show like cheesy pickup lines. And I fucking love their videos because they're like they're so weird, like the pickup lines. But then like her reaction to some of these, she like she doesn't know what to say, or she's like that's a good one, or you know whatever.
Right.
But like I'll sit there and like I'll scroll through their whole fucking feed of just their videos.
I gotta figure out a way to negotiate it. Because we can use it for promotion for 100%. But like, my personal one, okay, I've posted some stuff and it got some great reactions, but I don't know if I'm gonna keep mine. I really don't. It's just like, do I have 10 minutes to sit down and fucking dick around on TikTok?
Yeah.
10 minutes? I don't know. But we can use Headliner to promote it. But if you want to follow us on TikTok, it's at Inside You Podcast. As with everything else.
Right.
So that's, if I could figure out how to edit videos in that quick 15 second to 1 minute interval thing, that could be good for Spilt Liquor if we ever get that fucking thing off the ground.
Yeah.
No, that's fine. Now we're good now? Okay. I tell them, don't roll around the kitchen floor. What do? Roll around the kitchen floor. So, and now we're going to get... Oh, so speaking of our series in the 80s, last week's episode got taken off of YouTube.
Why?
Because I, in my infinite dumbass sleep deprived wisdom, used a 30-second clip of Call Me from Blondie, and RCA Records flagged it and took it down. So, on the right track. But it's still available on our feed because we can use 30 seconds or less without getting sued on the audio form, but we can't do that on YouTube. And I wasn't thinking. So, if you're looking for that on YouTube, well, you're shit out of luck. But you can find it on InsideYouPodcast.com, Spreaker, Apple, Google, whatever the fuck you listen to. Phonographs.
Pandora, Spotify, iHeartRadio.
The Pony Express.
We're everywhere.
Your sister's ass. Actually, that's a guy... That's from a guy that the Vic DiBattista. Have you ever heard of him? He went viral years ago, a couple years ago, for doing, I think, maybe a TikTok or a Vine. It's like, I gotta get the eggs and milk. That guy?
Yes.
He's a comedian. He's wicked funny. He just played the Monk Chong Opera House a couple months ago. I'm sorry I didn't get to see him, but follow him on TikTok because he's funny. This TikTok thing is really intriguing me. Snapchat, I don't know.
I mean, that we could totally leave up to her.
Maybe, yeah. Well, we have to sign off on it. It's not like we're just gonna let her go with it. We gotta sign off on it.
Well, yeah.
You already made one, didn't you?
No.
Oh, okay. This is the wrong year. Okay, so... series on the 80s, the decade of decadence, as it was called. Decadence and debauchery and fucking John Holmes got arrested for murder. You know, it helps that he was already on his way out and he had the AIDS. Stop doing porn. So we're gonna start the. We hope you liked the episode on 1980. 1981. Hope to be a little bit more in depth. I have facts about 1980 before we get to our top lists. So 1981. Dynasty premiered.
You don't have to watch Dynasty.
Yeah, that's on my
to
list.
Have an attitude.
Fucking yes. Dallas premiered, and Falcon Crest premiered. So, and what were they about?
I think they're all on my list.
Fucking rich white people.
Yep.
Falcon Crest. I was watching just Falcon Crest footage, and I see fucking Lorenzo Lamas. Now, Lorenzo not only Lamas does he was? Live, and he will continue to live.
That's an old episode. Go listen to it.
Deep cuts. I like to think
bringing it back.
I like to think we've evolved as a podcast. Bringing back to Lorenzo Lamas jokes.
Bringing it back.
But I've only seen Lorenzo Lamas in three fucking things: Grease, Falcon Crest, and I've seen some episodes of Falcon Crest, and Renegade. Do you remember Renegade?
Yes. Yep.
What a position.
It was like. It was like the execs at CBS were like, okay, so let's do, because I think it premiered after Walker Texas Ranger did.
I think so, yeah.
So let's take Walker Texas Ranger, but let's make him a biker. That's what that was. But they were all about rich white people all competing, ABC, CBS, NBC. And I think, I'm almost certain that Dallas won that.
I think
won
so.
That shit, because it's a dynasty. I don't, a dynasty is about oil.
Yeah.
Yeah? And they rebooted that.
Yeah.
Okay. Did they reboot Dallas?
I don't think so.
Well, fucking let's reboot Falcon Crest. Copyright Bill and Raptor. We're going to reboot it. Anybody have Lorenzo Lamas' phone number? All right. The DeLorean, the DMC DeLorean debuted in 1981. The most 80s car that's ever been made.
Yes.
How the fuck are you going to make gullwing doors? How are you supposed to open them in a cramped parking lot? You're going to park in the back of the parking lot. Ronald Reagan was shot in 1981, and, I don't like Reagan. A lot of people didn't like Reagan.
It is Ronald Reagan Day.
Hashtag Reaganism. What?
It's Ronald Reagan Day.
Is it really?
Yeah.
Oh, well, fuck him. you know what? He was a decent actor. I've seen Ronald Reagan pictures before. He was okay. Ronald Reagan, the actor? Who's vice president? Jerry Lewis. Sorry, I'm jumping years. I'm sorry.
You are jumping years.
1981, the longest baseball game ever played, took place 33 innings over 8 hours of baseball. I love baseball.
That's too much.
It's too fucking much.
That's like 7 hours.
Like, too much. If that happened today, and I got to see fucking overpaid Bryce Harper strike out for 8 fucking hours, kill me. Fucking kill me. They did finish it. A couple days later, and the Pawtucket Red Sox did win. It was like 3-2. After an eight-hour game, 3-2, that's it? Bullshit. So retroactively in 1981, and they went back a couple years ago and retroactively updated this, was the first reported case of AIDS in 1981. I thought it was later than that, 84, 85. Yeah. But they diagnosed this gentleman with something else. And retroactively, looking back at the case, he had AIDS. And 81 started all this shit.
Huh.
Bob Marley died in 1981, cancer. Now, for the life of me, now I don't really care for Bob Marley's music. I respect him as a musician, because he's excellent.
Yeah, he
was excellent.
Yeah, he was.
Son is excellent. But I thought he was murdered by his father. And all this time, I'm thinking about Marvin Gaye. Marvin Gaye. That's one of the funniest interviews. I was on a YouTube hole the other day, and I was watching Prince interviews for some fucking reason, because I think Prince is funny. And
did you? No, I know. Sorry, you mentioned Prince, and that just kind of sparked it. Did you see the Prince tattoo that she posted in the group chat? Because you didn't say anything about it, and I'm like, he didn't even say anything about that.
Oh, okay, reply. Heart. I replied. There. No, I dig it. I dug it. So I was in this YouTube rabbit hole, and I found a Prince interview, and someone was interviewing me. He's like, they were like, has anybody ever come to you with, like, a misinterpretation of your lyrics? He goes, yeah, somebody came to me and said, swore up and down that the lyrics were, dig, if you will, a picture of me, Marvin Gaye, and the kids.
I'm not going to be able to unhear that now. Like, I seen it on Facebook. I think he was, like, an English comedian where he did, like, misheard lyrics. And there's a Michael Jackson song, and I don't remember which one. But every time I hear it,
burgers are the best.
Every time I hear that song now.
Please let me staple the vicar.
Every time I hear that song now, that's all I think about. Thank you for knowing what I'm talking about.
Just let me staple the vicar.
I can't remember his name. I watch that video incessantly.
Every time it pops up, I would watch it.
I thought this poor broad's begging me for birdseed. You got me begging you for birdseed. Yeah, he's funny. Pope John Paul II was shot in 1981. A lot of shootings. Not a lot of stabbies in 1981. Just a lot of shooties. The McRib debuted in 1981.
Yes, bitch!
And I should have had the commercial queued up on the TV, because that's what I put the TV down here for, to queue up shit. The commercial is the most racist shit.
It's got
a funky slap bass in the back, and there's a black gentleman eating a fucking McRib. What do you call this, man? The McRib. It's stupid. And then, in 1983, the McRib went away. They came back in 89, went away again. 97, went away again. I didn't know there were such big intervals.
Yeah.
But, like, while we've been alive, it's gone away and come back three times. And guess what? It's fucking disgusting. McRibs, you like them, don't you?
I will eat one every time it comes out, just because. Because
it makes me think of the Ribicues from fucking high school.
Right.
And they were okay. And speaking of Ribicues and McRibs, so when Sophie goes to school, they give her lunch on her way out. So she'll bring it home. They gave her a Ribicue sandwich. It was a bread with a processed pork patty on it. With no sauce, and they gave her sauce on the side. Pickles on the side. I don't like pickles, but do ribs and pickles go together? No, yeah, I like ribs.
Those do.
I don't like pickles.
I didn't know, like...
Pickles! I'm sorry.
That's weird, because, like, Jay doesn't get anything, like, lunch-wise, like, when he leaves school.
Really?
Yeah.
Yeah, no, she always brings home lunch. Always.
Huh.
And they go to the same school.
Yeah, that's why I was... But the babies, oh my god. I walked in the house the other day, she's like, open the fridge! And I'm like, okay. Look, there's just, like, stacks of fucking milk.
Yeah, yeah.
Open the drawer, there's, like donuts and like, cinnamon rolls and a bunch of other shit.
Yeah.
Cereal, they, like...
I mean, hey, props to feed the kids, but, like, if I gotta throw out any more spoiled milk cartons, I'm gonna lose my shit.
Well, I mean, between me and... Jack, like, we go through the chocolate milk.
Oh, fair enough.
Yeah, like, that's the first thing to go, because it's Gears chocolate milk, and I fucking love their chocolate milk. Oh,
Gears chocolate milk is thick.
Yeah.
It's good stuff.
I love it. We'll like, go through that in, like, a day.
I don't know if this is on your list, but it was a thing that happened in 1981. The Waltons aired their last episode. I thought the Waltons was a more recent show.
Mm-mm.
But it... Good night, Jim Bob. What a fucking piece of shit show that is. I'm sorry.
It wasn't. My lists are, like, series that debuted that year, not
okay.
Something that, like, ended that year.
Okay. Donald Trump's favorite thing, aspartame, was approved by the FDA in 1981. Did you read that story about his Diet Coke button in the Oval Office?
No.
He had a Diet Coke button. He pushed the red button, and a butler would bring him a glass of chilled Diet Coke on a silver platter.
Oh my god.
This man was our president! I'm glad he's gone. Let's see. Donkey Kong premiered in 1981.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah. And in retro, and then apropos of that, so did Mario. Mario, whatever you say. We're on a big Mario kick in the house. Stacey's gonna be fucking kicking ass at Super Mario Galaxy. Hell yeah.
How is it?
It's fantastic.
I don't have that one.
It gets my fucking adrenaline going. Like, and I like Assassin's Creed, the Batman game, Spider-Man. Those games are all pretty, really, really exciting, but really predictable. This fucking Mario game has me fucking wanting to smash the TV.
I haven't gotten that one.
Yeah, we got a 3-pack. It was Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, which I hate, and Super Mario Galaxy.
Huh.
Yeah, Super Mario, it's really cool.
I'll have to get that.
They got a new one coming out.
Yeah.
Like, next Super Mario fucking something or other.
The one where he
has to save the princess.
Yeah. It comes out next Friday.
Oh, okay.
Which is also Logan's birthday, so.
Oh, sweet.
There we go.
You should get them Super Mario Galaxy for the birthday.
Well, so I had a Switch.
Mm-hmm.
And she knew I had a Switch.
Excuse me.
So I brought it up the one day, and I had it in my bag, and I was like laying in the bed, and Jack comes in and he's like, "Raptor, what's this?" And I'm like, and she's like, "That's mommy's Switch." And I'm like, "No, Jack, no. That's mine."
That's your second mommy Switch. That's mommy squared Switch. I brought it back.
So he goes for a couple days later, he's like, "Mom, can I play your Switch?" And I'm like, first off, it's Raptor Switch.
Well, let's see. So Prince Charles and Princess Diana were married in 1981, and we all know how that worked out. I'll tell you what, though, they're doing that show, The Crown, on Netflix.
Yeah.
They kind of covered Charles and Di's marriage. Shit that I didn't even know. Like, wow. The royals are pieces of shit.
Yeah.
And we, like, hold them in such high regard. Oh, God save the queen. MTV. MTV launched in 1981. The good MTV.
Yeah.
Not 17 hours of ridiculousness.
Yeah.
The IBM personal computer came out in 1981.
Hmm.
Yeah. Come a long way.
Yeah.
Fucking, I had just read Wapner. The People's Court debuted in 1981. Ray, did you fart? Wapner. Oh, Ray, it stinks. Well, sorry. I love Rain Man. Metallica formed in 1981.
Not a Metallica fan. Old Metallica, yes.
Ride the Lightning?
Yeah. I mean, up until early 90s. Like, early 90s.
Yeah, I remember, Lars is single-handedly responsible for taking down Napster.
Yeah.
Which, I mean, fuck you, Lars.
Right?
Now we gotta pay for subscription services. 81, Natalie Wood was, well, she died. Was she murdered? Only Chris Walken and Robert Wagner know for sure. No, she wasn't. It's my shitty Walken. She fell over the rail. Ow! That's crazy. It's nuts. What was that movie he was in with DiCaprio? Catch Me If You Can?
Yeah.
Two mice, fell into a bucket of cream. So sorry. I've been working on my Walken for years. All the impressions I do when I don't have a Walken.
Which is weird.
I can't get the inflection down at all. Because he's unpredictable.
Yeah.
Because sometimes he talks to you like a very posh gentleman. And sometimes like, wow! Oh my goodness! Oh, it's crazy! It's nuts! Oh, excuse me. Wow. My opinion. I think they threw overboard. But, okay. I mean, come on.
Yeah.
I mean, Chris Walken, I would buy if he was in the Mafia, but Robert Wagner, no. The whitest dude ever.
Yeah.
And then the Muhammad Ali fought his last fight in 81, which that was a long-ass run for a boxer. And he lost. He was already suffering from Parkinson's at that point.
Yeah.
But that's all the memorable shit that happened in 81. Now we get to the fucking, the chuffa. Of the shit Raptor who... Oh, no! My microphone just decided to go flaccid. Hold on. Why is that doing that? Okay. Please stop. Please stop. Please stop. Oh, it's going to fall completely. Okay. Technical difficulties. Fight amongst yourselves, children.
Right.
Okay.
Oh, there it is.
All right, so who went first last time?
I think you did.
I don't know.
I don't remember.
Okay, well, then you can go first.
Movies or TV shows?
Movies. Movies first.
All right. Indiana Jones and the Raiders of the Lost Ark.
Oh, fuck, Raptor. Oh, you did it. So, maybe 2 months ago, I went on an Indiana Jones marathon. Because they're all on, they were all on Netflix. I don't know if they still are. I think they left. But, as I was watching Raiders of the Lost Ark, I came to the realization that never before have I seen Raiders of the Lost Ark.
I like that one.
It's so good.
I like that. It's wicked good. That's one of my favorite ones.
Not much can be said for Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull. No explanation. However, they are making a new one.
Yeah.
And Harrison Ford's going to fucking come back. Stop.
Yeah.
I mean, hey, we all cheered when he came back as Han Solo. We all cheered.
Oh, yeah.
But he's got to stop with the Indiana Jones shit. And I love those Jones movies. But, okay, go.
Porky's.
This is like one of the most.
I just remember. You know, it's been a minute since I've seen that movie. And, like, I always remember, like, my mom talking about it and, like, people talking about it. The dude, with the part where the gym teacher grabs the dude's dick through the bathroom stall or something like that?
That is one of the most debaucherous movies ever made. Like, is there some, like Van Wilder? It's a pretty debaucherous movie. Animal House. Fucking Porky's.
I fucking love Animal House.
Porky's is on a different fucking level.
Yeah, it is.
It's on a. I do recommend it because it's really funny.
Yeah.
But.
Okay.
Oh, my God.
Escape from New York?
I've never seen that movie.
I don't think I've seen it all the way through.
But, I don't really like John Carpenter movies outside of horror. And he did that, right? John Carpenter?
I'm not 100% on that.
Or was that, am I thinking of something else?
That I'm not 100% on.
Okay, well, let's see. Wikipedia. I did not cue you up. Why are you doing that? Oh, fine. What did you order from Amazon again?
Yeah, all the notifications I get from Amazon because of our emails linked.
I know.
I'm like, what the fuck?
There's going to be a day where we don't, there's going to be a week where we don't order anything from Amazon, and they're just going to come to our house and be like, y'all all right? Escape. No. Escape.
Yeah, I don't think I've ever seen that movie all the way through.
John Carpenter.
Yeah, that I wasn't sure on.
Halloween is a fucking masterpiece. The Thing is a fucking masterpiece. John Carpenter's Vampires, really good. I don't really like him outside of horror. And maybe that's just me being biased because I'm a horror fan. I'll have to watch. Is it Kurt Russell, yeah?
Yeah.
I'll have to watch it.
The Evil Dead.
Oh. I love The Evil Dead. And I will say it again, that the remake is...
I still haven't seen the
fucking
remake.
Fucking amazing.
Have not seen the remake.
Damn it, Raptor.
I know.
One of these days, just log in to our Prime account.
I have Prime.
I bought it. So, yeah. One of these days, just log into my Prime video account and just watch it.
Okay.
Yeah. That password's the same as everything we do.
Okay.
Just don't order everything. Don't use my credit card. I'm trying to build my credit score. Don't use that.
Cannonball Run.
I hear many things about Cannonball Run. Never seen it.
I haven't either.
I don't even know who's in it.
I couldn't tell you. Top of my head, I could not tell you.
I want to say it's like Dom DeLuise, I want to say.
I honestly have no idea.
All right, maybe it's a Cannonball Run? Yeah, Cannonball Run. I have to look that up.
Scanners.
Is that the one where Michael Ironside's head blows the fuck up? Oh, man, that's a good movie. Yeah.
Yeah. Stripes.
Bill Murray?
Uh-huh.
Never seen it.
I don't think I've seen it all the way through.
I'm realizing that for all the movies I've tout that I've seen, I haven't seen a lot.
Mommy Dearest. Joan Crawford.
Yeah, that's it. I was going to say Jamie Lee Curtis, but...
Nope. No. Joan Crawford.
Yeah. Okay. Is that No Wire Hangers or that Rosemary's Baby?
That was Mommy Dearest.
Was the Wire Hanger?
Yeah.
Okay, I've seen that. Okay.
Yeah. Halloween 2?
No.
I actually didn't mind Halloween 2.
All right, so... Yeah, I guess we're deep diving into this motherfucker, right? So, Halloween 2, I don't think should have been made. I really... Halloween is a masterpiece. The first one.
Yes.
Part 2 is... All right, it takes place on the same night. Cool. Jamie Lee Curtis is back. It's supposed to be the same night. She's wearing a terrible wig. Terrible. Terrible wig.
Yeah.
And it was bloodier and gorier. And I don't know why that EMT had the hots for Strode. Just would not leave her. That was the kid from The Last Starfighter. Just would not leave her alone. Laurie, do you need anything? The shining moment of that fucking movie is where... They're checking.
Oops. At the text I just got. I can't read it.
Nope. Not touching that one. But apropos of that, the best thing about Halloween 2 is when Laurie makes it to the hospital. There's a small scene with the orderlies at the desk, and one of the orderlies starts singing, "Amazing Grace, come sit on my face." That's honestly one of the high parts of that movie. I don't know. And it wasn't directed by John Carpenter, which I don't necessarily have a problem with. I just think the guy who directed it is not a great director. Rick Rosenthal is not really, he doesn't really make any moves in the directing game. Or maybe it's just me nitpicking. Which is probably the case.
Probably, yeah.
Probably. I will go on record and say I like Halloween Resurrection better than I like Halloween 2. And that one had Busta Rhymes in it.
Right.
Busta. Pasta Cavassier, Busta.
She's wearing jeans with her tattoo. Wish me luck. That's the other text I just got. She has her tattoo on her thigh. And she's wearing jeans.
God help you.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what I say.
Mm-hmm.
And it's a big one.
Slap it. Real hard.
I asked her to if I could the other day, and she's like, "Go ahead, this is your one shot." So I go, and like I stop like right before, and she like flinched, and I'm like, "I'm not gonna hit it. Like, relax."
Yeah.
All right. History of the World Part 1. Mel Brooks. Monty Python.
No. I don't know if I've seen it. I don't want to give a definitive no, I haven't seen it.
It's good.
But I want to say I'm thinking of Life of Brian. So.
Why am I thinking, no, not Mel Brooks.
Mel Brooks was Life, no, Monty Python was Life of Brian. History of the World Part 1, Part 2 was Mel Brooks, right?
No. No, that was Monty Python. Why was I thinking Mel Brooks? I have no fucking clue.
Mel Brooks, Young Frankenstein. That's all you need to say.
Yeah. Friday the 13th, Part 2.
Another sequel that didn't need to be made. But I think that franchise is all the better because I think Jason sometimes is better than Michael Myers. Just put it out there. Don't fucking tag me in anything. I don't care. I like Friday the 13th Part 2. Yeah, I don't think it should have been made. But I think out of all the sequels, it's the most solid next to Part 4. Or the remake. Remake's pretty solid. I will fucking go to my grave saying that. Remake's pretty fucking solid. Willa Ford didn't need to be in it because she's not a teenager and she was acting like she was one. It's like she's the oldest, like she's the one buying all those teenagers the beer.
My Bloody Valentine.
See, I still haven't seen that.
I know I've seen the remake. I don't know if I've seen the original all the way through.
I mean, Jamie Lee Curtis was in that. Or is that Prom Night?
That was Prom Night.
That's Prom Night. Yeah, then I know I haven't seen Muldoon Anthony at all.
Okay, and this one. This one's for you, Melissa. Because you recommended this one.
Okay.
In one of our hangouts. The Monster Club.
Oh, god damn it. Vonderlaan, listen. I turned it off after the first 5 minutes. Now.
I have yet to watch it, but I saw that come up and I'm like, I started losing my shit. And I'm like, I'm putting this one in just for you, Melissa. So listen, here we go.
Listen here. Listen here. One of these days I will make myself a Long Island and a Long Island iced tea. And I will sit down and I will take notes about this bitch. And then we will have a Zoom call. I don't care if it's just me and her. And I will fucking record it and we will go nuts on the Monster Club. But son of a bitch, from even the pictures, from the promo pictures from the app, I couldn't do it. Couldn't do it. God damn it.
I still haven't watched it. Mad Max 2, The Road Warrior. I haven't seen that one.
Not a fan. I did like Fury Road. Came out a few years ago.
I haven't watched that one yet.
Quite good. Very, very good. You know, Tom Hardy as a replacement for Mel Gibson. Yeah, it is what it is. But Fury Road was pretty good. The original Mad Max is fucking... The Road Warrior? Really good. And then Mad Max 2 is okay. It's alright. Yeah, but I'm not a fan. But, like, subjectively, I could take it. Okay, it's an alright movie.
Alright, For Your Eyes Only. I don't remember who was in it or what it's about.
Going back to Wikipedia, goddammit. For Your Eyes Only. Oh, that's James Bond!
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Roger Moore.
Oh my god, why did I...
I don't need to Google that shit. What? That's fucking Roger Moore.
Oh my god, my mom would kill me.
she likes James Bond.
Uh-huh.
Roger. Oh, fucking, I got the Bond fever. For Your Eyes Only.
I normally do, too, and why did I just fucking blank on that?
Here's why. I'll tell you why. Would you like to know? It's because the Daniel Craig movies are so good that we kind of push all the other ones out.
But those old ones are good.
They are. Like, Dr. No is fantastic.
Yes.
Fucking... And I'll even make a case for The Living Daylights with Timothy Dalton, because I think he was a fucking fantastic Bond. And those films were violent. But that's why. Because the Daniel Craig ones are so goddamn good, and we keep waiting on this goddamn new one that keeps getting pushed back.
I still haven't seen the last one.
Spectre?
Yeah.
Spectre, it's a little lackluster. But I will say that Christoph Waltz is immaculate. Like, he is in everything. Like, just watch that opening scene in Inglourious Bastards.
I fucking love that movie.
Christoph Waltz is fucking amazing at everything he does. Yeah. Except for The Green Hornet. That movie can get fucked. That movie could, like, fuck that movie and its stupid ass. Seriously, I hate that movie. I don't want to hear this from a superhero. Because Seth Rogen played The Green Hornet. I don't need to hear that shit. No.
I've never seen it. I have no intention to.
it's 90 minutes. I'm never going to get back.
Okay.
Never.
All right, Clash of the Titans.
Sorry. Clash of the Titans. Is that Roger Corman?
Yeah.
Yeah. There's a special place in hell for those Roger Corman movies. Some of them are okay. Clash of the Titans. Who is in fucking Clash of the Titans? I was running out of my tongue. What's it? Harry something. Nope, don't care. But, you know, Roger Corman made a name for himself with those claymation, the cheap claymation shit.
Yeah.
And you know what? And I'll tell you what, I just found out the other day, Alien was supposed to be a Roger Corman flick.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
Huh.
I mean, I kept rewriting the script until 20th Century Fox picked it up. And you want to talk about another masterpiece? Fucking Alien is a masterpiece.
Yeah, it is.
Wrong decade, because that came out in 79, but still. Masterpiece. Aliens 2, masterpiece. Aliens 3?
No.
Alien Resurrection? That's fun. Prometheus?
That one was good.
Alien Covenant? It's up there, but it's still... you guys wrestling up there? Jesus Christ. What was that? Shut the fuck up, Sophie.
The Howling.
One of the better werewolf pictures to come out of werewolf pictures. I'm a Wolfman purist. Like Werewolf of London, Lon Chaney Wolfman. So yeah, like you're not gonna it's hard pressed to like I when I was younger I was a real werewolf fan. The Howling, Cursed. You ever see Cursed?
No.
The Wes Craven one from like 2005, Christina Ricci.
No.
It was okay. Even Underworld. That's a decent werewolf picture.
I love the Underworld.
I know you do, for a certain reason.
No, not just for her.
She's pretty. She's fine. But I'm pretty sure my wife has gone on record saying she's fine.
She's fine.
She was. Well, still is. But
and the accent. That's what does it for me.
Wikipedia. The Howling is a decent. That's Jack Nicholson.
Yeah.
Or is that Wolfed?
Wait.
No, that's the Howling. I'm gonna go. God damn it! Hang on.
Okay.
Wikipedia. The Howling. Oh no! I'm wrong. D. Wallace, Patrick McNee, Dennis Dugan, and Robert Picardo. What was the one that Jack Nicholson did? Wolf.
Yeah.
That's it. So, I may not have seen The Howling. I'm thinking of Wolf. Never mind. Okay. Wolf, I think, is really good.
I don't think I've seen that one.
That's Jack Nicholson and Michelle Pfeiffer.
Honestly, I don't think I've seen that one.
Yeah, it's okay.
All right. The Great Muppet Caper.
Oh, God. There are some Muppets. Nah, I love the Muppets. You know that.
Did you see they're bringing back the original series?
I did.
Disney Plus?
I did, God damn it.
I'm fucking excited.
Yeah. There are some Muppet things I won't even touch. The Great Muppet Caper is one of them. Don't like it.
No.
I don't like it. I don't like it like I didn't like that Muppet series they did on ABC a couple years ago.
Yeah.
It was like The Office with Muppets. Not a fan. I don't need 17 minutes of Kermit talking into a camera. No. Not a fan.
The Funhouse. It's a horror movie.
It sounds like clowns, and I don't like it.
Pretty much kids. I don't know if I can't remember if it was high school or, like, college kids, but they go to a funhouse, and...
Really? What's that called? I can't think of what the movie would be called.
I know I've seen it. I think I've seen it maybe, like, once. But, yeah.
I'll look it up. Maybe I'll have a double feature with Funhouse and then the Monster Club.
And the last one I have on my list, Madman.
Madman?
Yeah.
Who's in that?
I don't remember.
Madman.
Oh, now Swags is sending me TikToks.
Oh, Jesus.
She does that.
Madman film. Oh, it's a horror flick. Directed by plot revolves around an axe-wielding murderer named Madman Mars, who, after accidentally summoned by a group of campers during a campfire tale, begins to stalk and murder the young adults. That's what happens when you make such an impact with your first films, i.e. Friday the 13th and Halloween, that you get all these shitty ones. Is that it?
Yeah.
Yeah. Wrong year. 82.
I was 82? Mm-hmm. It was under 81.
Oh, maybe then. Well, when was the release date? Yeah.
Because I did films released in 1981. Release. Like when I looked up things.
It just made it. It was January 15th, 1982. So, yeah, you get a pass. That's all right. I'll have to watch it. I do sometimes like watching those old cheap ass ones that, like,
Friday. Some of the, like, and I mean, even now, but, like, some of, like the 80s, like, B horror movies are some of the best movies I've ever seen.
Well, except for Chopping Mall.
Well, yeah.
That doesn't even get an honorable mention. That's just a dog shit of a movie. Killer robot security guards.
Yeah.
It was funny when they blew up that girl's head. That was fun. All right, so we're going with top songs in 1981.
Okay.
Some of these, Now, I sent you, because we were going to do the episode last week.
Yeah.
And then we had to reschedule. But I did send you a picture, which got absolutely no reaction from you, and it pissed me off. Fucking absolute banger of 1981. I got nothing from you. It's not on this list, because it didn't make the top 20. I'm going off the year-end Billboard charts.
Really. Okay.
So that one with the honorable mention is Take It on the Run, REO Speedwagon. That is a fucking absolute banger.
Yeah.
I've listened to it every day since. Let's turn my headphones way up. Okay, so number 20. I Love You by the Climax Blues Band. Never heard this song. Don't care to. It just sounds stupid. But number 19, Slow Hand by the Pointer Sisters. That's a fine song.
Yeah, it is.
It really is. 18, which has been sampled by Will Smith on his 1997 album, Big Willie Style. Just the Two of Us, Grover Washington and Bill Withers. That's a good 80 song.
Like just Will Smith. Just the Two of Us. One. That one's, the original's a good one.
Make it if we try. Bill Withers just passed away.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's sad. That Ain't No Sunshine song is a good one to just belt the fuck out. Number 17, bringing it back to last week's chart, and the reason we got kicked off of YouTube, The Tide Is High, Blondie. Yes.
I love Blondie.
Blondie fucks.
Blondie fucks.
Blondie does fuck. Doing a cult to sew up Debbie Harry's vagina. Number 16, A Woman Needs Love by Radio.
I don't know that one.
No, I'm still learning a bit. Like, you know, I'm still learning. I'm still expanding my horizons with new genres of music and older music and things like that. But I've never heard of some of this. Number 15. Oh, they're back. Rapture. Blondie. Fuck yes.
Fuck yeah.
Fuck yes. Okay, number 4. Now, I know this song, but I didn't know who sang it. Queen of Hearts. Juice Newton. What a name.
Right?
That's like, that's not even a name that can cure cancer. You're, with a name like Juice Newton, you're doing B-porn movies. Queen of Hearts. Number 13, Being With You, Smokey Robinson. That's a good one.
Yeah.
It's a good one. Smokey Robinson's always pretty solid with his songs. Is he still alive?
I have no idea.
You know, I don't care enough to look it up, but I will after the show. 12, Morning Train, Sheena Easton. Now, I only know...
fucking love that song.
I only know of Sheena Easton because of Prince. Because weren't they were a thing, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
I fucking love that song. I remember the one day at work, I was singing it. Yes, there's porn on Showtime! Sorry. I just got a text that said there's porn on Showtime.
Yeah. Are people unaware of that?
She has my HBO Max and, like, my Showtime account, like, on her phone and all that. Like, so I guess she's going through. And that's the text I just got. Yes, baby, there's porn on Showtime.
Yeah. Yeah. She never heard of, like, HBO After Dark? Skinamax?
No! She's a baby!
She's an infant.
She's a baby!
She's an infant.
But, yeah, so when I still was at Walmart, that song... What?
Stacey just texted me and goes, Gigolos, bitch. There's a show on Showtime called Gigolos. And she watched the entire fucking thing. And I was...
Thank you!
Oh, wifey for the win.
Right?
Oh, we're going to have sex tonight. I was privy to a couple of these episodes of Gigolos. The most fucking ridiculous thing. Just these unqualified fucking man bags just humping away on these people.
So just to continue this.
Yes,
I'm sorry.
Please.
She's like, there's porn on Showtime? Holy shit. She's like, I know what I'm doing in the morning. Jesus
Christ. You have an internet browser on your phone. Just go to Pornhub. It's free. Well, I mean, all right, not in the long run, because you got to pay for, you know, internet provider and whatnot, and, like, you know, service plan, but still.
Like, it's not that good.
Do you think
like, it's not that
good. Do we think Showtime porn is better than internet porn?
Showtime porn is... All right. So...
We're getting off the rails here.
A little bit. Showtime porn is not that good. You're going to be disappointed.
Sure, a little context, because I don't think I've ever heard this song.
Fucking love it. I remember singing it at work one day, and the one girl was like, you know Sheena Easton? And I'm like, fuck yeah. But there's...
Don't take us off of YouTube. This is jaunty.
Oh, she just heard it on the podcast. That's why she... Have you seen the movie Eurotrip?
No.
Have you heard of it?
Yeah.
So, they... pretty much what it is... Sorry, off the rails again. But it has to deal with this song, so...
Okay.
This guy is talking to... Like, this pen pal through, like, school, like, the school thing, like, they had a, like, a pen pal thing, and he thought he was talking to some dude from Germany.
Okay.
And his little brother, like, corrects him, and he's like, no, that's a girl's name. So, the girl was gonna come to the States and meet him,
mm-hmm.
and, so he gets drunk and is pretty much like, fuck you, like, you're a dude, don't touch me.
Yeah.
And then the next morning realizes that it's actually a girl that he's been talking to. So him and his best friend go to try to get to Germany to meet her. But they end up in, like, England because they're doing some kind of, like, carrier thing to, like, get a cheap flight.
Yeah.
So they end up in, like, this football pub in England,
mm-hmm.
and it's, like, a members-only thing. So he starts singing that song, but he changes it.
Jesus.
All right, sorry, go ahead.
No, you're fine. So this song was a theme song to a TV show that I'm surprised was not, it might be on your list, I don't know. Hell yeah. I never thought I could be so free. I had a wet I fucking love this song.
Right. I don't know. No, it's not on my list.
Well, okay, so it's the theme song to The Greatest American Hero, which a dog shit show.
Oh, no, it is on my list.
Oh, it is?
Yeah.
Okay. It's an awful show. Awful. But, the theme song fucking slaps. I'll pull up the songs while we're here. So, number 10 is the same band who got an honorable mention.
Fucking love that song.
Mm.
That album is amazing.
Yeah. Was it High Infidelity? Yeah, it's on my list.
Should have seen by the look in my.
Fuck yeah, wrapped. Where's my lighter? Lighter's up. Okay, so number 9, I know you're gonna love. Because it's a jaunty song. Turn it up. While we're up, chokes. Now, if I'm not mistaken, I think this was on my previous list.
Yes.
It was.
Yes.
Because.
Yeah, because you're like, I don't like that movie, but that song. That song.
Song is a fucking toe tapper.
Right.
Let's see. Number 9, or 9 to 5. Number 8, I Love a Rainy Night, Eddie Rabbit. I've never heard that song.
I probably have.
I don't really care to look it up either. But number 7. People who found great success in the '80s, Hall & Oates. Kiss on my list. That song fucking
sucks. Yo, I have Hall & Oates saved on my phone. I'll just call it every once in a while.
So there's a hotline you can call. And I believe I posted a video a couple years back of it playing.
So the phone number for anyone that wants it is 719-266-2837. It really is saved in my phone.
Awesome.
Call & Oates.
Awesome. And you can call the number and select a Hall & Oates song to listen to.
Yeah.
And then you just listen to it.
Yep.
Speaking of that, we are on an app called Bullhorn. It's a podcast app.
Okay.
You can listen through your Wi-Fi, or you can stream it, or you can call a number and listen to it through the phone.
Really?
Yeah, I'll have to get the number. It's fucking weird. It's weird. It's weird to hear our show through a phone receiver because it's all crackly and shit. It's number six, Celebration, Cool in the Gang. Fucking hate that song.
Really?
Hate it. Number five, Rick Springfield, Jesse's Girl. No, that's all fucking.
That's a good song.
It's a classic, and it is. Okay. Number four, Just Like Starting Over, John Lennon. You never heard that song? It was on that double album with him and Yoko.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. All right. After Yoko ruined everything. three, He's Fucking Back. Lady, Kenny Rogers. I hate him so much. Fuck him in his stupid ass. number two. Now, this song is a classic, and I love this song. Endless Love, Lionel Richie and Diana Ross.
That is a good song.
My love. You know what? The best use of that song is when Happy Gilmore and that girl are skating to it, and Happy Gilmore, and the janitor is singing it. And then number one. Now, I hate this fucking song. I hate this song. Betty Davis Eyes, Kim Carnes.
I love that
song. I hate that song.
I love that song.
The best version of it I've ever heard is that classic Saturday Night Live skit where Eddie Murphy, they're doing an ad for Buckwheat Sings the Hits. And Eddie Murphy sings it as Buckwheat. It is fucking brilliant. Yeah, that's the year-end list. Songs, 1981. I can't wait to hear TV shows. I'm so fucking ready.
All right.
Give it to me raw, Raptor.
Dynasty.
Don't have to watch Dynasty to have an attitude.
Yo, you know what song I fucking heard from Prince that I don't think I've heard, but I heard it recently. I heard it recently. Cream. Oh my god.
Yeah.
First of all, it made me want to have sex with myself. This is like, that song is so sexy.
It's a good song.
Like, I'm like, should I masturbate? And then I heard an acoustic version of it on YouTube. He did an acoustic concert somewhere and first of all, I don't know if you know this about Prince, but he shreds.
Yeah, he does.
On the fucking guitar. And he does an acoustic version of it and it was soulful and I'm like, oh my god. I want to have sex with Prince.
And I'm the gay one.
Tiny little fucking good-looking black guy. Come on.
And I'm the gay one.
He's wearing heels.
He is wearing heels. And he pulled it off well.
He did. You know why? Because he just wants to be tall. He just wants to be tall. I've seen clips of Dynasty. I've never seen a full episode. Not my thing.
My aunt used to watch it. No, that wasn't Dynasty. I'm thinking of something else. I may have seen an episode. Who knows? All right. Elvira's movie, Macabre.
Elvira's touch and go with me. I think she's entertaining.
She is.
Fantastic rack.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not a tit fan.
You know, I think that's just part of her appeal.
It is.
That she dresses like a sexy goth girl. And she's still killing it.
Oh, yeah. I mean, even out of character, she looks fucking amazing. Like, she still looks good.
She's very attractive.
Yes.
For sure.
Alright, Entertainment Tonight.
Really?
Yeah.
I thought that was the 90s.
Nope, Entertainment Tonight.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Oh, you know what I'm thinking of? I'm thinking of Inside Edition. You meant to roll a joint?
Because, yeah.
I mean, please. Please do.
No, I'm not. Greatest American Hero.
Believe it or not, I'm walking on air. again, terrible show. Theme song slaps.
Harper Valley PTA. It was actually what a song. What is that? Harper Valley PTA.
Does that stand for Parent Teacher Association?
Yeah.
What?
There was actually a song. I think it was 60s, 70s. I don't remember.
Is it a TV show based on a song?
I don't remember, like, details, but I remember it being a song. I don't remember who sings it. Don't fucking ask me. I'm horrible.
No. We're going to YouTube. We're going to YouTube because I can't. Now I got to know.
Okay.
Because you say PTA, and I immediately think, welcome back. Your dreams were your ticket. Harper. No, it's the first fucking. Janie C. Riley, Harper Valley PTA?
Yeah.
I might have seen this pardon the ad. I might have seen this on one of those Time Life compilations.
Probably.
But hang on, wait for the ad to pass. I could have just gone to Amazon Music. I don't know why I didn't. What the fuck are you doing? Oh, it's country.
Yeah.
All right. Okay, I've heard it before. I don't like it. So they made a TV show out of this?
Yeah, pretty much.
Are there clips? No, I can't find anything. I don't care.
Okay. Moving on.
I hope she's dead. that was mean of me. I'm sorry.
Hill Street Blues.
Yo, I love me some Hill Street Blues. That's like a precursor to 21 Jump Street.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh my God, remember Ellie Law? That just popped in my head. Holy shit.
One of my favorite series.
Is it Saint Elsewhere? Please say it's Saint Elsewhere.
No.
God damn it.
I used to catch it on Nick at Night reruns, TV Land, Laverne and Shirley.
Hello. Yo, he just died too recently.
Yeah.
That's a shame. I used to watch reruns of Laverne and Shirley with my mother when I was younger.
I fucking loved Laverne and Shirley.
Never a Happy Days fan, ever.
I really wasn't either.
But I was more like reruns of the spinoffs, Mork and Mindy.
Yeah.
Laverne and Shirley. That show was legit funny. And you know, fucking Gary Marshall, fucking king of TV, just knocking it out of the park.
King of like every fucking thing he touches.
Everything. And then he shows up at fucking Hocus Pocus as Satan.
And his sister as his wife.
That was weird. That was fucking weird. Like, I understand, like, they're both of them.
I mean, fucking Penny Marshall.
Penny Marshall's a fucking genius.
Amazing.
And that was weird. But, like, Master, will you dance with us? It's like, this is fucking Gary Marshall. We watched that for Halloween. And
I watch it every year.
I forgot that he was in it.
I watch it every year.
It's the only thing I could tolerate Bette Midler in. Because, I mean, beaches? Ew, fuck you.
No.
I hate beaches.
Ew.
Hey, the Sanderson sisters!
But I love me some Laverne and Shirley.
Oh, God. There's an actor. His name is Daniel Roebuck. He was in Rob Zombie's Halloween as the manager of the Rabbit in Red. Okay? He's from Bethlehem. I don't know if you... That has nothing to do with this. They did a TV movie in...
Oh,
like,
your Amazon order shipped.
Thanks. Thanks for the heads up. I gotta stop using the podcast for this horseshit. They did a TV movie about behind the scenes Mork and Mindy. And Daniel Roebuck played Gary Marshall, and it was fucking spot on. And I'm talking about spot on. So shout out to Daniel Roebuck for being a fucking boss and a local. All right.
The New Adventures of Zorro.
Oh, God, no.
Yep.
See, you know what? Zorro is such an old property that you can't really justify making it okay again. They did two of them with Antonio Banderas, all right?
Yeah.
So the first one was fucking amazing.
I don't think
so
I've seen
good.
Them.
But then the Legend of Zorro was dog shit. It's such an old property. It's kind of like if they brought fucking Errol Flynn back. It's like those kind of like Robin Hood type movies.
Yeah,
can't really justify those. And they keep trying to make Robin Hood movies.
Yeah,
and they're awful. What was the last one with Taron Egerton?
Yeah, no. I haven't seen it.
No.
I mean, no. Like, except, you know what? The previews actually didn't look bad, but I'm like,
You know what Robin Hood movie did work? Fucking Kevin Costner.
Yes.
It's fucking Morgan Freeman as Little John. That was pretty good. Andy Dufresne. I'm working on my Morgan Freeman, too. Robin Hood.
The Smurfs.
No, fuck me running.
I remember watching that as a kid, too. I was at my grandmother's house, and I'd watch the fucking Smurfs.
Is that joke assistant manager Rob made years ago, the old man wrist looks like Corky Miller? Those Smurf pictures, the Smurf movies, from the 2010s, they're not good.
No.
But the cartoon was very good. It was really funny. I'll go back and watch them if I ever have the time.
Spider-Man.
Now, hold on. That's a TV show.
Yeah.
It was live action.
I don't know.
If it was Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends, which came out in 1980, because you did that last
episode. No, 1981.
No. Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends, you said came out in 1980.
Nope.
81 was His Amazing Friends?
81, because that's my last one. Thank you for giving that away.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm going back and looking at my...
Oh, you know what? No, that was Super Friends.
Yes, Super Friends.
Okay. So... Yeah, so there was a series in 1981. I'm very familiar with the show.
Yeah, Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends were my last two.
So Spider-Man and His Amazing Friends was Spider-Man, Iceman, and Starfire.
Yeah, because we were talking about Super Friends, and then that's when...
So the Spider-Man show that you're referencing, and I know it because it's like unfucking believable how this thing got produced. So they changed it to where he was bitten by an alien, and he wore a motorcycle helmet, and he rode a spider cycle. It's awful.
Oh, okay.
It's kind of like when they did that kind of the superhero team up of the old Incredible Hulk series when they brought Thor in.
Okay, yeah.
And it was fucking Bill Fagerbakke who was the voice of fucking Patrick on SpongeBob. Yeah, that show should never ever been produced ever, 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 ever. However, sidebar, did you see episode 5 of WandaVision?
Yeah, I watched it last night.
Fucking what?
Well, we watched it last night, and again, she fell asleep, last maybe like 10 minutes. Mm-hmm. But that ending, I'm like...
I've been watching fucking reaction videos, and some dude lost his shit so hard he threw up.
Like, I don't want to say anything, because I don't know if she's going to watch it before she listens to this, but...
Now, mind you, I haven't seen any of the series.
Dude!
I read the spoiler, and I'm like, that can't fucking be true.
Dude!
Okay, first of all...
You need to watch it.
I don't know why you're yelling at me. Second of all...
You need to fucking watch it.
Okay, first of all, I don't need the kind of tension in my life right now.
You need to fucking watch it.
I'm saying to her, we gotta watch it.
They bring back Kat Dennings. I'm such, like...
Okay.
No, like, seriously.
No, I'll watch
seriously.
It for her. I'll watch it for her.
Seriously, you but, need to watch it.
Yeah, I don't, who's
like, that's,
we can't
like
talk
our,
about
our,
it without spoiling
our,
it, so.
I know, that's been, like, our weekly, like, Friday thing, like, that's what we do.
I knew they were gonna mesh those things together, but I didn't think they were gonna do it there.
Bam. You need to watch it, it's okay. So good. Like, at first, I know, you and I talked about it.
Yeah.
At first.
You said it was, like, a slow burn, at first.
It is. Like, the first episode, a little bit of a slow burn. I'm like, I was like,
the thing is,
and then because they released the first two episodes at mm-hmm. once. So we watched the second episode and I'm like, huh, okay. So then we started, and that's been like our weekly, like Friday thing.
So here's the thing though. So that thing that happens in episode 5, she's not going to understand. She's never seen any of the other movies. So I don't know. I'll have to give her like a quick refresh.
Yeah.
But, yeah, it's pretty.
But oh my god,
fucking
like,
money.
And even no, like I not really too far up on like like storylines and stuff like that. But the, like, there are some things like that I pick up on.
Well,
that,
I mean,
that like stuff that like I know that happens within some of the storylines.
This is the first thing that happens after Endgame, right?
Yeah,
it's the first Marvel property that's come out since Endgame. So, yeah.
Okay. But like, there are some things that are mentioned or like little just hints of things that I'm like, huh, okay. And then like after I watch it, like I'll go back and read like some articles of like Easter eggs that are in it.
Mm.
Like I did pick up on a couple, but it was like some of those, like I picked up on it, but I wasn't exactly sure like how it fit in. And some of the articles that I was reading, like explain like where in like the actual storyline that it came from.
So, I mean, so, everything I read says it's a pretty unique kind of deal. With
it
Marvel.
Is.
And we can always expect Marvel to fucking knock it out the park.
You really need to watch
Except
it.
Except for Thor 2. I'm kind of shit the bed on that.
You really need to watch it though.
Okay. So top selling albums of 1981. So I have a list of 11.
Okay.
Cause I had to compile them from multiple sources, Rolling Stone, and other places. So 11 is for those about to rock. We salute you. AC/DC. AC/DC is touch and go with me.
Yeah.
Cause it's just, everybody hates on AC/DC, I think, because they're so kind of like generic metal, but Marvel's use of it for Tony Stark. Fantastic. 10. This was for you. Tattoo You, the Rolling Stones. I know you would like that.
Yeah. I've seen them in concert a bunch of times. Like,
Yeah. They still rock, even though they're
old. Oh, yeah.
Mick Jagger has a deep reservoir of, like, rocket sauce.
Yeah.
And just, you know, just keep... Dude's like, what? He's in his 80s, isn't he?
No, he's up there.
He just keeps going.
Yeah.
And Keith Richards. If only Mick Mars from Motley Crue keep going like Keith Richards.
Yeah.
I would love to see Motley Crue in concert.
I saw that like twice.
Eat my ass.
But I mean, even when I saw him, I mean, that's going back maybe like 10 years. Like, Mick Mars could still hold up.
Yeah, that's fair. But I mean, he's ill a lot of the time.
Yeah.
By the way, most of these are fucking absolute destroyer albums that are just like pinnacle albums from the 80s. 9. Escape. Journey. Everybody loves Journey.
Great album.
Did you see that thing on the playlist on Spotify? Songs to get the white people turnt? And there's like all the Journey songs are on there. All the big Journey hits. It's when Journey was good.
Yeah.
That's when Journey was good. I will say that they're decent now with that Oriental fellow. That seems really racist, but I don't know where he's from. But, what's his name? Arnel Pineda. He sounds just like Steve Perry. Just like him. Fucking 8. Belladonna, Stevie Nicks.
That's such a good album.
Like a wild winged dove.
Fucking yes.
Such a good album.
That song comes on, that bass hook comes on, you have to turn the shit to 11.
Yep.
Have to. And then fucking Destiny Child sampled it and ruined it. But, number 7. 4. A Foreigner. Another fucking banger. This one, I didn't know, I think, because we covered her on the last episode, but number 6, yeah, is Precious Time, Pat Benatar.
I love Pat Benatar.
Everybody loves Pat Benatar. Feisty little short midget thing. She's really tiny, right?
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
That's
from my mom, Stevie Nicks, Fleetwood Mac, Pat Benatar.
Oh, like, Fleetwood Mac, yeah. Yeah.
That's all from my mom.
When I bought the record player upstairs, I made sure to get, like, Brenda, give me a copy of Rumors, because she had two. I'm like, I need one. She's like, all right, I'll be right over. That and The Stranger by Billy Joel. I needed that album, too. And I bought that for Amazon. 5. Long Distance Voyager, Moody Blues. Not a Moody Blues kind of guy.
Some of their stuff's good.
Nights in White Satin. Fuck that stuff.
Some of their stuff is good.
Not
like a huge fan, but...
Number 4, Mistaken Identity, Kim Carnes. God damn it. Son of a bitch. Billy Davis. Oh, God. I've never had a song maybe make me want to be ill before. Like, physically ill. Three, Paradise Theater sticks. Solid.
Yeah.
Sticks song is pretty solid. Two, High Infidelity, REO Speedwagon. That entire album is fucking gold. And then number one, Double Fantasy, John Lennon and Yoko Ono. I hate Yoko Ono with a passion. Fuck her. Fuck her in her stupid mouth. I hate her.
Most people do.
I don't think she's the reason the Beatles broke up. Like, the sole reason. But she is a major contributor into mm-hmm. why they split. There is an album, and it's a bootleg album. It's never been released. It's called A Toot and a Snore in 74. It's the first time John Lennon and Paul McCartney got together after the Beatles broke up. And Stevie Wonder was there, and I think Steve Winwood was there. And they're all fucking doing cocaine. And jamming.
Okay, great.
John Lennon can't get his shit right because his microphone goes out. And he keeps begging Stevie Wonder to do the cocaine with them.
Do you want a toot, Stevie? A snore, it's going around.
35 minutes of that. Yeah, that's it. That's it. If, I'll put it out to you, the audience. What's your fucking favorite shit about the 80s? There has to be something. Whether, and not just year specific, anything from the 80s. MTV, Back to the Future. I mean, I'll suck Back to the Future's dick. Talk about a masterpiece. It's the only really good masterpiece Robert Zemeckis has ever made. I mean, there's Forrest Gump. That wasn't really a masterpiece, though.
No.
So it's a good movie. Back to the Future is a masterpiece. It's lovely. We just got done selling at work all the Funko Pop Back to the Future shit because of its 40th anniversary.
Yeah.
They had figures from the animated series. I'm so tempted to buy them all. And then when I shaved my face, I got called a bald Biff Tannen. So I ran away at work. Says, "Fuck you! Why don't you make like a tree and get out of here?" What was that? Part three, or one of Buford Tannen's fucking corrects him on one of his things. Says, you know, that was Biff's thing. Make like a tree and get out of here.
Yeah.
Fucking that up. Dead as a... You'd be dead as a doornail, dude. No, Buford, dead as a duck. Something like that. I don't know. I fucked up that joke. But, thus far, even in the whole 80s decade, besides our births...
So... It was like earlier this week or something like that. I don't know. We were coming back from somewhere and I had the last of the 1980 episode coming or playing. And you're like, something you like about the 80s? And she's like, my girlfriend. And I'm like, yes, I get it. I was born in the 80s. You were born in the 90s. Yeah. It's fine.
Oh, come on. Like, listen, we were born in the 80s, but like we were born so, like, Roger was born in 86. I was born in 87. So, I mean, we were born in the back end of the 80s, so yeah. We don't remember much. But it, you know, being as we were born in the 80s, we get a pass for liking it. And yeah, okay, so technically we're millennials, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. I wish we weren't. I really wish we weren't. But on the bright side, it just means that we're young enough to still appreciate the old shit. All right, we're old enough to appreciate the old shit, but young enough to still appreciate some of the new shit. Which, you know. But yeah, so, yeah. What was your fucking favorite part of the 80s? I really want to hear it. It'd be really fun if you told us.
Right.
I think I'm going to go ahead and say on record right now that my favorite thing that came out of the 80s is Back to the Future.
My big thing was a lot of the music. I'm a music fan.
Mm.
You know, growing up, like, I listened to the Rolling Stones, Styx, REO Speedwagon. Like, I listened to all of that. I think that's like one of my like my favorite like some of the music that came out in that decade.
Oh, don't get me wrong, I love 80s music. And it's only been recently, maybe the last 10 years, I've really gotten steeped in 80s shit. Like, I always Journey, stuff like that. But, like, obscure songs, like, fucking My Sharona, that's a popular song. But, you know, the knack was like a one-hit wonder. Fucking Blondie.
Fucking love Blondie.
Billy Joel's big fucking, his career soared in the 80s. Because but he was recording since the 60s. But he went fucking batshit crazy in the 80s. I love 80s music, but I'm more of a, I go really kind of older. Like, I like listening to, like, the old doo-wop shit.
Yeah.
Like, doo-wop playlists, like, fucking Temptations, The Platters, fucking Bobby Darin. I was just playing Mac the Knife the other day on my record player. My mother got me this big thing from my last birthday. It was a big compilation album of old shit. As doo-wop and stuff, Frankie Lyman and the Teenagers, and fucking Mac the Knife was on it, and I was like, it's about to get turnt in a Thick Penthouse. fucking Dion, Run Around Sue, fucking love that song. I had people say I was born in the wrong time. That's subjective. But, I do like older music. Yeah. Not like, you know, he was a famous trumpet man from out Chicago way. Like, all right. Boogie Bugle Boy Company B. Yeah, it's a fucking, that was the banger of 1929.
Like, I grew up with all that, though.
Yeah.
Like, so, like, I have a love for music from every fucking decade, but I think the 80s and how I grew up and what I listened to, like, even some of, like, the 80s, like, rap, R&B, like, that stuff, like, I love that
stuff. Are we
stuff
talking too. About, like, KRS-One?
Yeah.
Yes.
You know, it's weird, like, I go through
just these... a steel town girl on a Saturday night.
Right?
Yes, bitch.
Like, I go through these spurts where I will, like, right now, like, my Pandora, I love The Weeknd.
I will say that he successfully made an 80s album in 2020.
Yeah.
God damn it, if that album isn't really good.
Yeah. Like, I've been going through this thing where, like, I've been listening to The Weeknd, and...
What was that fucking song you told me to listen to, and it was fucking... It made me want to strip. Call out... That one?
Yeah. Love that song.
God damn it. He's talented.
Yeah. But there are times, like, I'll go back, and, like, I can just fucking listen to, like, 80s music.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. But that's how it is written.
It is the stereotypical 80s music.
Yeah.
Like, because when I put on the 80s playlist, it always starts with In the Air Tonight, and then it ends with Don't Stop Believing. And I don't know. There was a lot of, there's a resurgence of 80s music when I was in high school. Like, the kids in high school love listening to 80s music. Journey, fucking Motley Crue, Bon Jovi. Kid, not fucking love Bon Jovi. What else? Fucking Debbie Gibson. Tiffany.
Yeah.
Being Very Alone. And what a fucking stupid song. Green Day's version of it is very, very good, though. What else? God. You know, that's the shit we used to do. We used to burn CDs and fucking throw on a little bit. Like, if you burn a CD in 2004, you're going to get... The first song is going to be Hot in Here by Nelly.
Yeah.
The second song is going to be Don't Stop Believing.
Yep.
Yeah. That's the shit we used to do.
If it wasn't the second song, it was somewhere on that playlist.
Mm-hmm.
Every CD had that song on it.
I'll tell you that the first place I heard Don't Stop Believing, the first time I actually heard it, was in that movie Monster with Charlize Theron. And her and Christina Ricci are making out behind the trailer. That's the first time I ever heard a Journey song.
Really?
It was a lesbian experience.
Okay.
It's fucking crazy. And it fit the scene, but that's the first time I ever heard Journey. All right, I'm going to have to change my answer. The music. You know, most of the music that I listen to that comes out of the 80s is heavy on the synthesizers and fucking, like, Fox Seagulls. Like, weird shit. Gotcha, goo goo. Fucking Bananarama. That fucking Cruel Summer song.
Right?
Was stuck in my head after the season 2 finale of Cobra Kai. Because somebody covered it, and it's really fucking good. It's like kind of like a slow EDM version of it. And it just would not leave my fucking head. So then I went and listened to the original one, and it's so good.
Yeah.
And that music video is ridiculously 80s.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, God.
Oh, yeah. Like, I don't know. I have a soft spot in my heart for 80s music.
Yeah, for sure. Sure. I've been listening to the same fucking playlist for a week now. Go away, 9 to 5. Home. Recently played. Where is it?
Yes, Walmart. I know my order is not complete.
Your frequent plays. The Hamilton soundtrack.
Of course.
Thrice, To Be Everywhere, To Know, Be Nowhere. That album snuck back up on me. And then 80s rock ballads. The first song.
Yes, bitch!
Heavy on the synthesizers. Yep. It's like a part two of songs to get the white people turned. This song slaps so fucking hard.
Right? And like, I mean, you've met Ashley.
Yeah.
When she can fucking rock out to like 80s love ballads with me, like I'm like, yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
I kind of just want to let it play. But we will get sued. Oh, fucking.
Yes! I love that song. Mm. There is, and I know you don't like them, but hear me out. The current singer from Nightwish.
Okay.
Covers this song.
Okay.
Fucking amazing.
Is it on par with this one? Like,
yes.
Like tempo and time signature?
Yes.
Okay.
She does it live. It's just her. But, I mean, and I'm not really a cover song person.
I'm a cover song person if you could do it right.
Yes. She does it justice.
Like, that cover of Cruel Summer was fucking, it's a good cover. But for the emotion they were trying to portray at the end of the season 2, ooh, right in the dick, right in the dick, Raptor, or the vagina, right in the pagina, right in the bajingo. I do like covers, like
if they're done right. I'm not like cover songs. I'm like, but then I'll listen to it. I'm like, okay.
When I went to see Daughtry in 2009. They did Daughtry did a cover of In the Air Tonight, and it was fucking pristine. It was so good. His voice matched it so well. And they brought in synthesizers, and the drummer, who was playing in his underwear, by the way, which I always found weird. But as a drummer, it does get hot. We sweat. I'm like, I haven't played drums in years. Luke, dude. He keeps, we gotta get together and play the music. All the time. But he played the drum solo with glow sticks. His drumsticks were glow sticks. Lost my shit. That was the concert that Theory of a Dead Man opened for Daughtry, yeah. And I fell asleep. Which shows you how much of an impact Theory of a Dead Man has on people. Crappy band. Yeah, 80s music. I mean, my favorite song that came out of the 80s is Dream Warriors by Dokken. That song slaps so hard. I don't even care that it was on the soundtrack to Nightmare on Elm Street 3. It's so fucking good. It's so good.
It is a good song.
And I don't know anything that Dokken has ever done before or since. But that one fucking song makes me fucking feel, makes my white loins fucking feel all fuzzy.
White loins.
It's my White Snake cover band. White loins. I think we're going to end on that note, ladies and gentlemen. Listen, hit us up with your favorite shit in the 80s. Find us on Instagram, Facebook, TikTok. Put us inside you at gmail.com, inside you with Bill and Raptor at yahoo.com, or Friendster. I mean, we're technically not on Friendster, but I mean, throw a rock. Maybe you find us. Who fucking knows?
InsideYouPodcast.com.
InsideYouPodcast.com. Yeah, that we most definitely are on there.
We are.
That's ours. We built that. For Inside You with Bill and the Raptor, I'm Bill.
Raptor.
And we're pulling out. Bye.